All right, how's everybody doing? I know it's been a while, but I'm back on YouTube. Well, it's your good friend Kronos here. How you doing? And I am doing this video based on a dare. Yeah, so... yeah, I forgot what I was doing, because I was like just surfing the internet one day. And I was just thinking about like certain movies I was watching. So yeah, I'm thinking, I was watching something and I felt like popping in an old 80s classic movie, right? So I actually felt compelled to watch this. Mm-hmm. So what the movie I'm watching? V, the classic miniseries from the 1980s. Now, a little bit about this. This movie was written and produced by one Kenneth Johnson, right? Yeah, now V, as you may or may not know, is a timeless masterpiece because it's an analogy to the rise of fascism in Europe. Specifically, the coming of the Nazis, and the movie has a variety of analogies, you know, to fascism and the Holocaust. You know, they kidnap all the people. Heck, throughout the movie, right, we have Mr. Abraham. He's a character played by the late Leonardo Cimino, is it? But yeah, like you got this Holocaust survivor commentating on what the visitors. Those are the aliens in question, on how they're changing society, like changing America from a democracy into a fascist state. Yeah, the movie is, the original miniseries is very well written. And it's become like a pop culture icon for all time. Right? Yeah. So I was telling my good friend Elaine, yes, Elaine. She is the one who kind of put me up to this little challenge. Can I watch both V and V the Final Battle? Yeah, she's like telling me, isn't the second half of V schlocky? And I was like, Elaine, if you want to hear about schlocky, watch V the Final Battle. So she said, go ahead, do it, which I just did today. So anyway, the classic V was a huge ratings hit for NBC. Yeah, it's like in the early 80s, man. They had Star Wars and Star Trek. I know Kenny Johnson wanted to do a miniseries movie called It Can't Happen Here about the rise of fascism in the United States. Kind of like what people are saying about Donald Trump. But that's a debate for another time. So anyway, right? Yeah, it was a very well written, and the network had very high ratings in that movie. Because of that, NBC wanted to make an instant sequel, which I happen to have in my collection. V, the Final Battle. Unfortunately, Final Battle is not the masterpiece that its predecessor was. Yeah, where do I even begin with the Final Battle? Well, let me see. Well, there are numerous continuity errors between this and this. For example, the police officer that joined the resistance. In the original movie, his name was Brad. In the Final Battle, they call him Mark. In the original V, Ruby in the Final Battle was given a good Christian burial, which flies in the face of the original, where we find out that Ruby's Jewish. Heck, she too was a Holocaust survivor who, like, along with Abraham, was explaining how evil the visitors really are. So, yeah, there's a whole bunch of continuity errors, people's names getting mixed up, events not making any sense. Well, if you really want to see from the get-go things not making sense, okay, now I'm being a little nitpicky here. Daniel Bernstein wearing that brown jumpsuit. So, like, 1 minute, I'm dead serious. 1 minute in the same scene, he has the regular uniform, right? Regular visitor youth. And then they look at the medical students, and then they go back to him. He has a gold trim collar on. How that happened so quick, right? But aside from the continuity errors, the right end, basically poor writing and overall disregard for what Kenneth Johnson did. You know, they're trying to make Donovan and Juliet boyfriend and girlfriend. No, like, very campy, very. And they had decided to bring in resident NBC tough guy Michael Ironside to be Ham Tyler. Yeah. Well, the writing was horrible. The script was, like, totally stupid. Yeah, no, the plot was meaningless and pointless. It's like V, the Final Battle. It doesn't have that much of a connection with V, per se, right? It's basically just a 6 hour long action flick with V characters thrown in. Yeah, well, another difference I observed is that they seem to have a slightly bigger budget, because now they have, like, more people playing shock troopers, and now they got that new uniform, the security division with the gold trim and stuff. Yeah, and the spaceships flying around, they seem the network gave them a little money. But yeah, the writing was atrocious. Yeah, I was looking up on Wikipedia. It said that Kenny Johnson got so frustrated with what the network was trying to do, he quit the team. So they just credit him as Lillian Weezer. Yeah, and I think I could tell the part of Final Battle that Mr. Johnson wrote. You know, when the resistance fighters are storming the facility that's supposed to be an analogy for a concentration camp. No, but, like, from then on out, the movie gets real stupid real fast. You know, basically, that's the only part that the beginning was the only thing Kenny Johnson wrote. Either he quit or what I see happening more often than not, the network kick him out the team. They kicked him out, and they went ahead and... Basically, Final Battle gets more and more ridiculous as time goes on. You know? Get the cheesy action sequences, poor acting, you know? But at the climax of the movie, when they wanted to turn the mothership into a nuclear device, well, that was a thing we did in the 80s. We were fearful of nuclear annihilation. So that kind of made sense. That, okay, they'll turn the mothership into a nuclear bomb since the resistance is winning against them. But, oh, you got the space child. No, star child. You know, she's supposed to be half human, half visitor. Because if you remember from the classic, right? Diana authorized some medical experiments. One of which was, could a lizard, because that's what the visitors are, lizard Nazis from outer space. Oh yes, I did forget something, didn't I? Yeah, before I go on, just to clarify, originally Kenneth Johnson wanted to do a fascist movie, right? But like I said, with the popularity of Star Wars and Star Trek, he changed his story to be about space Nazis. These Nazis come from outer space. Anyway, one of the experiments was, can a lizard impregnate a human? You know, at the end of the classic movie, it was implied that Robin Maxwell was pregnant with a visitor child. It was implied. But with Final Battle, they just ran with it. Got her, like, morphing into lizardish features and eating raw meat. And I'm like, what the hell am I watching? Rosemary's Baby? Yeah. And the Star Child, who manages to invoke magical powers to disarm a nuclear device. And, basically, you combine all of that, you have one crappy miniseries. You got one crappy miniseries, yeah. Oh yeah, just when you think it can't get worse, it actually got worse. Yeah, NBC figured, right, okay, Final Battle got decent ratings too. Why not make it a regular TV series? Well, I can't really review it per se because I don't have that DVD box set of the television series. But I did see it when it was on the Sci-Fi Channel. And if you thought Final Battle was horrible, the TV series was an atrocity. You know, because they didn't have any real money at the time. Well, at the 1980s, special effects were not as practical as they are today. So yeah, you get more plot holes than a slice of Swiss cheese. More cheesy alien gimmicks. And I'm like, okay, what am I watching? You gotta be kidding me. Yeah, that snooze fest only lasted for about one season. And then fast forward to the modern era, ABC Network wanted to do the remake of V. The remake of V had less to do with the classic V. Less as in nothing. Yeah, the one that was on ABC, I know they tried to get the nostalgia going by having Jane Badler and Mark Singer, Diana and Donovan from the classic miniseries, come on in guest roles. So Diana was an alien leader and Mark Singer was a leader of a secret government agency supposed to fight the visitors. That's where the remake ended. I know this video is like basically me ranting about how horrible V the Final Battle was. Yeah, compared to the timeless classic that is the original. See, but the original was well written. No, you tell the stories. It's not a story. It's the classic V was multiple stories going on at the same time. And the thing that unifies all these different threads is the coming of the visitors and how different people deal with it. Now, they show you, like in the beginning, Donovan is filming a civil war in Central America. Robert Maxwell was doing anthropology and Juliet Parrish was in med school. Then these guys come from outer space. Began their subjugation of the planet Earth, and everybody dealt with it in his or her own way. And the characters were like introduced so well that you had a vested interest in what happened to them, right? And it's like, how did these aliens take over the planet so quickly? You know, trying to ostracize scientists and using propaganda to get people to go along with them. No, it was a cautionary tale of what happens when fascism shows up at your doorstep. Right? The special effects were pretty good, actually. You know, practical yet attractive. No, but like I said, V is not about special effects. It's about the story and the people and about who the story depicts. Yeah? And I like how at the end of the first V movie, they kind of leave everybody hanging. Like, okay, we're going to send a signal to outer space. Right? To find the enemy of the visitors, right? Because Martin mentioned it when Donovan found out that they were not here looking for that life-saving chemical. No, no, no. The reason the visitors came to Earth was to steal the water and turn the human race into food. Soylent Green. Soylent Green is people! They're eating people! Yeah, turned that, right? So Martin tells Donovan that some of the, not all the humans are going to be used as food. Some of them will be used as foot soldiers in the leader's army to fight the leader's enemies. So at the end of the original V, they're sending a distress call, hope to God that the visitor's enemy picks it up. Well, funny thing is, like about 20 years later, Kenneth Johnson came up with his own sequel for V, a book he titled V, the Second Generation, in which the Earth has been under the subjugation of the visitors for 2 decades, and how they've taken half the water off of the planet, turning it into a desert. The visitor's enemy finally shows up and tries to get in good with the resistance who have been fighting a losing battle. So the insect people, that's who the visitors were trying to fight. Yeah, they came in trying to work with the resistance, and yeah, the resistance thinks everything's about to go good. And but then guess what? The ZT, the little insect people, they have an ulterior motive in helping the humans throw off their lizard oppressors. Well, I'm not going to get into that because right now I'm not here to talk about the book. I'm just here to talk about these two movies right here. Classic V, Final Battle. So like I did, I actually could not believe what I was watching. But just to explain it to you, this is the good one. This is the schlocky one. Well written, poorly written, outstanding, cheesy. Yeah, that just about wraps it up. And Elaine, if you're watching, Elaine, if you're watching, I got you to thank. I have to actually thank you for getting me to sit here and analyze both of these movies. Right? Yeah, so I'm saying, right? I guess, well, I'll end off with this. I remember when I was in college, I was talking to one of my professors, right? Well, it was a history. He was a history teacher. And, well, half the time, he taught the history of the Holocaust. So he and I were talking after class. And I was suggesting, like, maybe 2 movies he could use when talking about that particular bit of history. What it was... The Classic V, and I think The Diary of Anne Frank as another movie. So, I actually brought the copies to the class, and he, like, jotted down these, numbers in the back of the box, so he could, like, check it out for himself. But, yeah, like, the way The Classic V works out, putting historical context, putting the history into a format that the young people can understand. So V, the classic miniseries, is something you actually show, because in a way it's sort of educational. Yeah, it's educational look at humanity. You know how high we can reach, and how low we can go. Yeah, so the classic V is very meaningful. Wish I could say the same for the sequel. You know what I mean? But it is what it is, right? Well, I'm just about to end this little dialogue right now, and I'll upload to YouTube. And last thing, if you like any of my sci-fi videos, feel free to hit the subscribe button just below the movie screen, the red button that says subscribe. Kindly click on the subscribe button to go subscribe to my YouTube channel, where I have a bunch of other sci-fi videos from conventions and other times I've looked at movies and TV, and the commentary I did when Leonard Nimoy passed away. So yeah, do that, and I will definitely see you in the future.